there was an interview that was done, and this was on Good Morning America, where the Secret Service director, she referred to the attempted assassination on Trump as unacceptable, and she said it was a security, I mean, she told ABC that a security breach led to the assassination attempt. I guess this has to do with the fact that the dude climbed on top of the rooftop where it was the staging area for the local tactical for crowd control and all of that stuff, that it was the staging area. I mean, it's unbelievable. Listen to this, because this is some of the, this is just a bit of her interview where 23, where she also says she's not going to resign over this. Listen.
Who is most responsible for this happening?
What I would say is that the Secret Service is responsible for the protection of the former president.
So the buck stops with you?
The buck stops with me. I am the director of the Secret Service. It was unacceptable, and it's something that shouldn't happen again.
The president and Homeland Security Secretary said today they had 100% confidence in you, but there are some members of Congress calling on you to resign.
I appreciate the secretary's comments, and we're going to continue to be transparent and communicate with people.
Do you plan to stay on? Absolutely.
I do plan to stay on.
Yeah. She had a really bizarre reason, too. She was saying that there was explaining why there wasn't an agent on the roof where that the killer opened fire. And when she was talking about the Secret Service, like the multi-tiered approach they had, Kimberly Cheadle, described as in battle. And this warehouse, again, was 147 yards away from where Trump was positioned. And so the story came out last night, and this was brought up in this ABC interview, where the killer managed to evade cops and Secret Service three separate times. He had already been 30 minutes prior. He apparently was deemed a suspicious figure. And apparently, an agent even took a photo of him before he opened fire. Like, someone was able to take a photo of him before he opened fire and started killing people. And all of this, there are a million questions. She said the decision was made to secure the building from the inside, is what she said. What? She said, well, he was actually identified as a potential person of suspicion. Unfortunately, with the rapid succession of how things unfolded, she said in this interview broadcast by ABC, that by the time the individual was eventually located, they were on the rooftop and were able to fire off at the former president. That's what she said in this interview. And she said that they were aware of the Secret Service was aware of the vulnerabilities, and the decision was made to not place personnel on the roof. And that's when she said all of that before she said, the buck stops with me. Wow. That is unbelievable. If you haven't watched that interview that ABC ran this morning for Good Morning, was it Good Morning America, I think? Wow. How in the world? So you secured it from the inside, and that was pretty much it. That was it. You secure it from the inside. All of this 30 minutes before, suspicious person, minutes before, people were saying, there's somebody over here, do something, and yet nothing was done. And apparently, they were, you know, the snipers that were, or the crew that was inside the building, they spotted him scoping out the building, but no one stopped him. And that's according to CBS. They said that motive's still unclear, really, you think so? They said that there, all these details still coming out. They also discovered rudimentary bomb-making materials found at his house and his vehicle. And he apparently was able to kind of run around and do whatever he wanted to. I understand that there is this inclination to think that, And to think that there's conspiratorial things at play here. I really do, believe me. I understand all of that. And I wouldn't blame you. Because we've all just lived through, how many years? Almost 10 years now of government agencies being weaponized to either thwart or go after innocent people. Or undermine free and fair elections, like in 2016. I get all of that. But that said, there is something I think you need to consider about this. Think of how incompetent our government agencies are right now. Think of how incompetent they are. Think of how incompetent the Department of Transportation is. United States Postal Service. Name a government organization and think about the level of incompetency. I tend to think it's less of a conspiratorial thing and more of a systemic epidemic of dumbassery that has infected every level of government because it's too big, number one. I just simply don't believe that there are enough smart people to staff the government to that effect. It's too big and it's filled with morons. That's what I tend to think. And this is kind of the result of that. It should always be a priority to have, you know, a stash of food and water, a lot of days worth of food and water ready to go if you need it. You'd rather have it and not need it than need it and not have it. Have your emergency plans made. Make sure that you can boost your family, your own resilience against potential or prolonged power cuts, cyber attacks, floods, other natural disasters. With ReadyWise emergency food, you're covered, not just for the worst, but for adventures as well. I mean, you can enjoy peace of mind knowing that you have delicious, nutritious meals at the ready. And they're perfect for fishing, for hunting trips, hiking adventures, even if you want like a last minute meal. ReadyWise has a huge selection of freeze-dried meals, everything from breakfast to pasta dishes. And you can be assured that your food will be good to eat when you need it with their 25-year shelf life. ReadyWise is an all-American company with their state-of-the-art plant right here in the U.S. of A. So that means you're supporting American jobs, too, when you choose ReadyWise. Visit ReadyWise.com and use promo code Dana20 at checkout for 20% off of any regularly priced item. That's ReadyWise.com, promo code Dana20.
That building in particular has a sloped roof at its highest point. And so, you know, there's a safety factor that would be considered there that we wouldn't want to put somebody up on a sloped roof. And so, you know, the decision was made to secure the building from inside.
There's this meme going around that shows Bane from Batman, you know, throwing his arms up like this. It's this meme format, and you see his back, and he's facing off this guy in a pink onesie who's much smaller. And he's got his arms extended. And the Bane, the text over Bane says, the biggest, baddest, highest budget security agency on the planet. And the little man in pink, the words over him say, a slightly sloped roof. I mean, we literally almost descended into chaos because of a slightly sloped roof. Really. That was Kim Cheadle, head of Secret Service, trying to explain why she didn't have the rooftop covered. But I thought that that was local law enforcement's area, so she can, even though she says she didn't cover it because it was local law enforcement's area, she can also apparently bar people from getting, I'm confused. And it was the same type of roof that the counter snipers were on, but okay. Welcome back to the program. Dana Loesch here with you. We are at the top of this second hour. And I'm really shocked at this. What in the world? It's a slightly sloped roof, as you know. There's a safety factor, and so the decision was made to secure the building from the inside. That's what she said. So they didn't get on the roof because it was slightly sloped. And she was afraid someone would slip and fall. But they were on the same type of roof, the counter snipers were, but okay. That's the stupidest damn thing I've ever heard. She's in charge of this stuff because of a slightly sloped roof. That's what she said. Quote, the building in particular has a sloped roof at its highest point. And so there's a safety factor. We didn't want to put someone up on a sloped roof. Well, that's it. You know, you can just take over the United States with a sloped roof, slightly sloped roof. They're actually trying to. So wait, the snipers that were on the slightly sloped roof, the counter snipers that on our side, that was okay. But not on that slightly sloped roof for some ever whatever reason. It's too dangerous for the snipers, you know, on the roofs with the direct line of sight to President Trump, you know.
The counter sniper's roof looks even more sloped than the actual sloped roof where the, you know, attempted assassination took place.
Yeah.
That's odd.
You think? Just a little odd?
Just a tiny bit.
Just a little bit odd. I'm amazed at the, I mean, I'm not amazed. This is a level of absolute dumbassery that it's embarrassing. And Kane and I were talking about this on break, actually. And again, if you're just joining us, you can listen terrestrially around the country. You can stream the video component of the radio program on channel 347 DirecTV as well. There's a chat over at Rumble, all kinds of good stuff. We're on X, all of that. I mean, this is just the dumbest
thing. You think it's just incompetence. I believe that it's more than that.
Okay, but my belief that it's just incompetence stems from the fact that I think people in government are the stupidest people on earth.
You're not going to get an argument from me on that.
I don't think they're smart enough to do something like that. You can never underestimate my complete lack of regard for the bureaucratic agencies that act as our overlords. There's no way to overstate how much the loathing, you know?
Oh, I get it.
And how dumb I think they are. How stupid and moronic and probably products of like generational incest they are.
And I agree with you 100%. Yeah. I just want to be clear that I agree with you 100% on that point. Absolutely.
But for me to accept that there's like a conspiratorial angle, I'm not against it. I just don't think any of them are smart enough to do it.
Yeah, because you think it's them that are planning it. It's not them that are planning it. Why do you think some deep state entity would put...
I think deep state are morons, too.
Well, that may be...
I don't have enough fingers on these hands smart to give enough them, so I'm just going to give them all.
You can do that on television. Thank goodness. But the deep state, I think, they know. They're incompetent, yeah, but they're smart enough to know to put morons in place of power. So that then eventually if things go wrong and not up to what they were planning, they have a fall guy. They have a fall guy. And just like this, it looks as though Cheadle is going to become the fall guy. And maybe if this was a
Paula
successful.
Paula Blart, you mean?
Yeah, Paula Blart.
I'm not calling her Kim Cheadle. She's Paula Blart.
But if this was a successful assassination attempt, she would have been the fall person.
I've seen better security at Claire's Boutique in the mall. Y'all remember that? Only the real ones do. Only the real ones do, right? Like the KB Toys with the little yip, dogs in the front. Better security there during Christmas.
You're not focusing on my point.
I'm just saying, I understand what you're saying. I think they're all dumbasses,
yes.
Including deep state. They're all the products of generational incest. Yes. That's why they think this stuff's going to work. Is that mean to say? Because I really do mean it. I'm not actually joking when I say it. Whenever I hear people go, I'm going to grow up and work in the government, I'm like, you're literally a walking mental abortion. That's what you are. Like, your dream in life is to go up and be on the public teat. Like, you're just like a, you know, at least strippers go out and work for their money. Good grief, you know? Thanks for watching The Dana Show. Make sure to like, subscribe, ring the bell, and stay tuned for more content.